And obviously, you brought in back Tyreik Wright after a successful loan the previous season. In terms of that, were you made aware by the scouts, or did you watch some videos, or were you aware of Tyreek's performances the year previous with Bradford? Or is it normal for clubs to go back in for a player that's previously done well on a loan? And was it hard to convince him to come to you again for the second time around?
That's a long question, that one.
Yeah.
So no, I think just along the normal recruitment lines, I think we what it was, the first thing we had to do was try and get the numbers down to a manageable level because they were too big before January. So we managed to do that. We felt defensively we were in a good place as a team. I felt we had struggled to score the amount of goals we needed to be successful. So we identified what we needed. So it was first of all, what does this squad look like? We weren't just, oh, he's available, let's take him. We had to look at players, or look at the squad, sorry, and look at the team and say, right, we need this, we need this, we need this, and right, who is out there to help us bring these certain skill sets to our team and our club? So we brought, obviously, we were adamant we were bringing Jake Young back, which was a big one for us. We brought in Callum Kavanagh, and we brought back Tyreek Wright. So I'd spoke about having people with mobility and pace and a goal threat. So they were the sort of things that I spoke to Ryan and Stephen about, and then we set about trying to find those certain individuals. And there was more, obviously, there was a lot more than the three that we did sign. And obviously, we had to replace Harry Lewis, who moved on, and we brought in Sam Walker. So, but I didn't want to have a massive turnover player. I think January window is a really difficult window. I think we were quite disciplined in what we wanted to do because we felt we had to trim the numbers down to then give the squad the opportunity to perform. And but unfortunately, with Tyreek, he got injured in his first game. Came back, scored two against Accrington, got injured in that game. So it's been a difficult time for Tyreek, but he's training well at the moment, so hopefully he's back up to match fitness.
And Graham, when you assign loan players in January, do you look at them for maybe a short-term view towards the end of the season, or is there even a possibility of a long-term interest in terms of that when you look at a loan signing, or is every loan signing have different scenarios attached to it?
Yeah, they're all different. I think look, there's some players that are, we don't know about their parent club's long-term ambitions for that player, whether they might be available in the summer or they've got high hopes for them in their club and they just send them out for experience. So they're all different scenarios. If there's an opportunity for us to do anything with a couple of loan players, then we would certainly be having those discussions going forward from between now and the end of the season. Yeah, all the loans are in different sort of aspects and different scenarios around them. But the biggest thing is, can they help us try and win games? And that's what we try to do in January.
Yeah, and you mentioned there about that sort of 10-day madness in March that really sort of upset your sort of season in terms of that sort of push for the playoffs and that. When you're in that sort of bad bubble, as I say, in terms of a manager, when you're in that sort of when things seem to be hitting the fan, as the saying goes, with those five games, is it really hard to see inside out? Is it hard to put a figure on where things are just disintegrating so fast until you get out of that bubble and you turn the other corner and then you can see, oh, well, maybe it was a certain thing there that's what caused that run of form?
Yeah, well, we try to break it down to individual games. So it's, after the first defeat, we broke it down to, right, what did we do that brought that game, that result on? And then we try to correct it for the next one. But, games can turn on moments. And what we've found in those games is we, certainly the first one against Forest Green, we conceded after 50 seconds or something, put ourselves on the back foot. I think we had about 80% possession for the rest of the game, and we just couldn't break them down. It was very difficult, as you can see with other teams that do that. And then obviously we came up against Mansfield and Notts County, the high scoring teams in the division. It just became a little perfect storm over that time. But what we try to do when we get the Harrogate game was the biggest one for us because we, you know, it just wasn't a performance we wanted to be a part of. You know, that was it. And so we actually, you know, we just spoke to the players on the next day in training, and we tried to settle everybody down. We didn't try to sweep anything under the carpet, but we did. I just don't want any group of players or staff to just look back and mope and moan and groan without trying to do something about it. That's it. I think the best thing to do in any of these scenarios is try to find what we can do better, and then try and put an action plan in place, so we're actually doing something to make it better, rather than just wishing it or just hoping or just bitching and whinging about what's gone on before. I think the most important thing is having a proactive mindset. Right, these are the issues. How do we overcome them? How do we improve upon them? Let's put them into practice. I think the players have tried to take that on board. We are not going to go from that group of games to a perfect team performance week in, week out. It doesn't happen that quickly. But the players and the team have shown good progress in the last two games to come out of that little black hole we were in for. And it was 2 weeks. You know, that's the thing. It was like quick succession. It wasn't like a month to 6 weeks of bad form. We were the second highest in the form table before those 2 weeks, and those four games really knocked the stuffing out of what we could potentially achieve, I felt. But the players have shown a good response in the last two games, and I think the supporters have responded to that as well. Certainly after the last two games, I think they've shown their appreciation to the team. And the only way we can ever achieve anything is everyone is trying to support each other through thick and thin, through good times and bad times. Everyone can have their opinions on what we could do better. I understand that, and that's I respect that gravely. But when we get onto that pitch or we get to that stadium, everyone has to be on the same boat if we can be. But our responsibility is to you know, invite the fans onto that boat by playing and perform in a way that justifies their support.
And final question for me, Graham, in terms of motivation now on the field for the end of the season, we know all the good stuff going off the field in terms of Bradford City at the moment. Is it really, are you setting the targets now? Is it up to the war chart, or is it top 10 finish? Is that the realistic, the aim for Bradford City to get inside that sort of top 10? I mean, that's points wise, that's a realistic target, I suppose. Financially, finishing higher up the table, where you finish obviously gives you a net sort of reward as well in terms of that. So is that the real incentive now to finish inside that top 10 maybe for the end of the season?
I think that for me, our incentive is to show people that we're serious about winning. We're serious about making this club a better club. That we want to repay people's faith. We want them to be on a part of this. It's all on the emotional and side for me, that they see a team that they can be potentially proud of in the future. We haven't been successful in what the club set out in last summer. I don't think that will be achieved this season. Could be torn out of place, but let's be honest. But there's still things that we can show that in the future we can create a successful team here. The players, the staff, myself. That for me is that there's always a pride of how you handle yourself, win, lose, draw, in how you act, how you aspire to be in the future. And we're trying to, hopefully in the next few games, we will give people the belief that things are better in the future and there are good things to come.